Having a new member here today, so I'm gonna just hang back and wait until she gets here.
What have you got there, James?
This is Abby's letter.
Who's Abby?
Is that short for Abigail?
Oh, she's the new member.
Abigail. Sounds familiar.
I don't think I know an Abby.
She wrote you a letter?
Well, no. I stole this from her.
Stole it? Well, what's in it that's so valuable?
Are you blackmailing her?
Oh, shit.
You know, so that she actually shows up.
What? I'm not blackmailing her. Why would you ask me something like that?
Well, don't yell at her.
You're right. I'm sorry. I think we should get started with the rest of the meeting.
I have something to share.
Is it progress or pain?
It's progress, I think, but I just need to get it off my chest. It's about that girl.
The one from last week?
Yeah, the girl that I was talking about last week.
Hello?
You're here.
Yes, I,
Look, you don't have to come here for your little note. Just take it back.
Is this the club?
Yes.
I realized you were right. I do need someone to talk to.
Come on in, then.
So I finally asked her out on a date.
Oh, you finally did. When was this?
Just this past Monday. I did it in person and everything. I thought I should at least try to be genuine about this, right?
She asked a girl out? And what did she say?
She said yes.
So you have a girlfriend now?
Yep.
You did it wrong.
I'm sorry?
Well, you asked the wrong question. What you asked was, what does she say? But what you should have asked is, how does she feel?
How does she feel?
Oh, no. Not how does she feel, but how does she feel?
How do you feel about that?
Well, I'm honestly irked.
Irked?
Yes, I'm irked.
Why are you irked, Kay?
Because of how easy it was. And how painless it really is to ask a girl out. I mean, it wasn't so hard at all, so why do guys make it out to be this awful and terrifying thing?
You're irked because guys make asking girls out look hard?
No, I'm pissed because guys make it look so hard. I'm irked because she said yes so easily. She didn't even think about it. She just said yes.
Just yes?
She gave me a little kiss too, but it just makes me wonder, do I really like her that much? I mean, am I actually ready to do this?
And so you're irked because...
I'm irked because she likes me too much.
And you're afraid. Because it sounds like you might not like her back.
No. No, I like her. I'm just a little confused.
Is it commitment?
Kinda. I mean, I'm not even sure if I am lesbian. I don't think I'm ready.
No, that was a lot better.
Thank you.
I don't understand why she's here.
Just forget about it. Don't start with her.
I don't like her.
Huh?
I said I don't like you, Abbigail Higgins.
Well, I'm sorry to hear you say that.
Do you remember me?
I think I recognize you.
We used to go to the same middle school. Remember?
Isn't your name Stephen?
Yes. My name is Stephen.
Well, I remember about you, but we never really met.
Sure we did. I was in your classes.
But we never actually met.
But do you remember anything about me?
Well, I remember you were like the smartest kid in the class.
See, she remembers from back when I was smart.
Stephen, don't start with this again.
I beg your pardon?
Well, nothing about you. It's just that. It's just like you said. I was smart.
And you're not anymore?
Stephen here is smart. He just doesn't think that he is.
I'm not smart anymore.
Stephen.
I'm not smart anymore, and I know it. It's my problem. It's why I'm in here anyway.
Stephen, don't be so hard on yourself.
Stephen, you're fine. It's not a problem.
It is a problem. It's my problem. I used to be the smartest kid in the class. The 4.0, you're going places. Top of the class, smart ass, try hard kid. And then high school happened. My brains went for shit, and my family went for shit, and my grades went for shit. Now I can't even find the focus to find out what I'm gonna do with my life. I don't know where I'm going. I don't know who I am. I don't know who the fuck I am anymore.
Stephen, we understand.
No, you fucking don't. Did high school get to you?
What?
I remember you were one of the smarter kids in middle school. Are you still doing all right?
My grades? My grades aren't nearly as good as they were in middle school, but lately, I don't know, I guess I've just been trying not to give a shit.
Stopped giving a shit. I wish I could stop giving a shit. All right. I don't hate you anymore. All right? I'm cool now. Sorry.
I don't get it.
You don't get what?
This club. What even are we supposed to be doing here?
Well, all we ever do here is talk.
About our problems.
To feel better.
And to get things off our chest.
Okay, so you all have problems.
We all have problems.
Right, I'm sorry. We all have problems.
We forgive you.
But I don't get the circle.
Well, the circle represents.
And the lamps.
The lamps are symbolic of how light can kind of...
Right, and it's not about seeing each other, it's about seeing inside.
And darkness is an analogy.
And the name.
You don't know the name?
No, I know the name, it's...
The Moron's Ox Club.
Yeah.
I never told her the story.
story?
Well, of course he doesn't know the story.
The story!
There is an old story from an old folk town that tells of a tormented boy who washed up one day on the shore of the town of Puppet. This boy was neither known nor recognized, but was immediately taken care of by the local townsfolk. They, the people of Puppet, told the boy that he would soon be home, to which the boy merely responded, "Ox." Confused, the townspeople believed that the boy must have suffered from injury upon washing up from the coast, an injury so bad that now all he could say was ox. But the boy was brought back to health, able to walk, able to work, and able only to say ox. And when the people realized that the child belonged to them now, the ridicule began. The boy became a man, and the man became the moron of Puppet. You see, that's what they would call him. They would call him a moron, and he became known as the moron of Puppet. The moron who could only say, ox. This lost boy turned man, turned laughingstock of the town, grew sick and depressed of the ill-bearing humor. So one day he decided to turn his back on the town of Puppet. And when they asked him where it was he was going, he said, defiantly and with pride and with all the strength in the world, ox. And the puppets of Puppet never saw the moron again.
Wow, who came up with that story?
That story belongs to all of us.
That story is the very definition of this club.
But who came up with it?
Well, that hardly matters.
But it's a pretty great story, don't you think?
Everybody knew about the moron of Puppet, but nobody ever knew if he ever found its ox.
James, I don't think she got it.
That's because the story is full of shit. It's a clever work of fiction, maybe, but it's full of shit.
What's gotten into you, Addison?
What's gotten into me? Gee, is it my turn to talk now, guys?
What? I'm sorry, did I say something to hurt you?
You asked me to tell the story.
I never asked you to tell the story.
I always tell the story.
But you tell it so well.
But is that all I am to you guys?
Addison, you're so much more than that.
All I ever do here is tell that stupid story. Not once have any of you guys asked me how my week was. You know, on any given day, I might walk past one of you guys at school. Not once have any of you guys said a word to me outside of this room.
Outside of these walls, we are strangers to each other. It's one of the foundations of this club.
It's like I don't exist if I'm not telling you guys a story.
Addison, I'm gonna be honest. I don't really know you, but may I say...
Addison, be honest. Look me right in the eye and tell me right now that you're not being the slightest bit excessive. Addison, what are you doing? Where are you going?
What are any of us doing?
So what about you, Abby?
What about me?
What's your problem?
My problem?
I think he means, why are you here today?
Shit. That fucking thing.
To keep things short, I hate myself. I hate who I am, and I wish that I would die. There's something missing in my life,
that.
Or something I need to get rid of. I don't
James,
know what it is,
please.
But if I don't find out soon, I'm going to kill myself. I'll kill myself, and just like that, I'll be done with it. Signed, Abby.
Hey!
What's wrong, Abby? Why would you write someone like this down? Why would you decide to kill yourself?
That letter isn't real.
Then why would you write someone like this down?
It's not a suicide note. I'm not actually gonna kill myself. I would never.
Why would you write someone like this down then?
I wrote it for a lot of reasons. Where would you like me to start?
Is this a joke? Did somebody put you up to this?
I wrote it for me and my issues. Why would you even read it?
Issues? How does faking a suicide deal with your issues? What kind of morbid treatment is that for a girl like you?
A girl like me?
Yes, a girl as popular as you.
Popular? I am not popular.
Okay, you're not popular. What are you then?
I'm miserable.
Oh, come on. Everyone is miserable.
Well, then I feel miserable.
Oh, you're the only one in the world who's ever felt miserable, so you get the right to want to kill yourself? You don't get to joke about things like that. You don't have real problems. You understand that, right? I would kill to be in your position. Right now.
I feel miserable because I do the same things every day. I wake up looking forward to the same things and then I go to sleep day after day. People tell me that I'm special, but I'm not. I'm just like you guys. Unhappy. And I have all these so-called friends, but the truth is I haven't felt a connection to anyone since like seventh grade. And that hurts, knowing that you have all these people to turn to and not being able to do it either way. I have all these people who love me, but none of them seem to give a shit about what I do.
If they don't give a shit about you, then I wouldn't say they love you.
Maybe. But I know that some of them really do love me. If they can love other people, why can't they love me? It's just, why can't I love me? Why do I hate myself so much?
What happened to not giving a shit?
Yeah, but that's for school. I really do care about me, though, and I'm just afraid. I'm afraid of being alone.
Would you ever consider killing another person?
What? No. No, why would you even ask me that?
Then why would you say that you would kill yourself?
Because it's a fantasy, don't you get it?
What?
It's not a punchline, it's a fantasy. Saying that you'd be willing to kill yourself. Everybody wants to stop doing the same things over and over and over and over again. So we'd say we kill ourselves. We say it because it seems like the easy way out, but none of us have the guts to actually do it. But that's part of the fantasy. You say you'd kill yourself. You'd say that you have the guts to actually stop, but you don't. None of us really have the guts.
Suicide is real, Abby. You're gonna justify it by saying that it's just some fantasy? It's okay to feel that way?
I know that it's wrong. But I'm not telling you because I think I'm right. I'm telling you because you asked.
I had a cousin who committed suicide. I loved him very much, and he loved me. But he hated himself. You know, people always used to say that in killing himself, he showed that he was weak. That he was too weak to handle the world. But those people didn't know him like I did. He wasn't weak. He was brave. He was so, so brave. And like you said, he had guts. And that's what killed him in the end. The fact that he had more guts he had love. So, it means a lot to me, Abby, that you would say that it takes guts. But we don't need those guts. We have each other.
You're also full of shit.
What?
I said you're also full of shit.
Sometimes I feel so happy. Sometimes I feel so sad. Sometimes I feel so happy. But mostly you just make me mad.